Minha senhora, senhores ministros, senhor vice-primeiro-ministro, senhores embaixadores, minhas senhoras e meus senhores. As minhas primeiras palavras são para saudar Vossa Excelência, senhor Presidente e sua excelentíssima esposa, e para lhes apresentar, em nome do povo português, do Governo a que presido e em meu nome pessoal, os nossos melhores votos de boas-vindas. Constitui para nós uma grande honra e é motivo de enorme satisfação podermos acolher, com a qual temos mantido sempre relações de estreita amizade e cooperação. Saudamos em Vossa Excelência o nobre povo americano, mas também o governo americano, que tem ajudado o Portugal democrático, saído do 25 de Abril, a solidificar as suas instituições livres, através de um apoio permanente à luta que temos travado, e a compreensão e o apoio que os Estados Unidos nos manifestaram nessas horas muito contribuíram para reforçar em nós o sentimento de amizade que sempre nutrimos pelo povo americano. O fim das guerras coloniais permitiram a reinserção de Portugal no quadro de um relacionamento normal com os restantes países do mundo. A luta difícil que tivemos que travar, no sentido da abertura de Portugal ao mundo e pelo retomar do diálogo com os países até então fechados, o desenvolvimento económico e social do país, de modo mais justo. Para tanto, científico e tecnológico, visto que acreditamos na sinceridade do seu desejo de cooperação e no seu espírito de solidariedade. Senhor Presidente, Estado-membro, no mundo conturbado em que vivemos, dilacerado por conflitos sangrentos e por constantes atentados aos mais elementares direitos do homem, têm os responsáveis políticos a correr aos problemas angustiosos da fome e da miséria, quando se vive preocupado com a defesa da segurança e da paz no mundo. Daí que nos congratulemos das tarefas de desenvolvimento das zonas mais desamparadas do globo. As especiais ligações estão com o MATI e apoiamos na América Central o trabalho do Grupo de Contadora, orientado no mesmo sentido. Senhor Presidente, a entrada de Portugal na CEE, que estará concretizada a 1 de janeiro próximo, traduz e esperamos que venha a contribuir para o reforço da unidade europeia, tão indispensável à defesa do mundo ocidental. Uma Europa forte, num brinde pelo futuro do grande povo americano, pela felicidade pessoal de Vossa Excelência e de Sua Excelentíssima Esposa, minha senhora, pelo reforço da amizade luso-americana e por um mundo mais pacífico, em liberdade e em justiça.
Come here to Sintra, this green and enchanting place that Lord Byron called a glorious Eden. We can now sense what he felt when he penned those words. But the magnificence of Portugal is not merely found in the grandeur of landscape and scenery. Overriding the loveliness we see is the sculpture of your land is the soul and spirit of the Portuguese people. Prime Minister, we Americans take great pride in our frontier heritage and in our love of liberty. And when it comes to pushing back frontiers and to the commitment to human freedom, our two peoples are as one family. 5 centuries ago, the Portuguese were the pathfinders who led the way to a new era in the history of mankind. Like Americans, seeking new horizons is so much a part of your national character. Portugal's many experiences or achievements during the Age of Discovery are a great source of pride. Today you have equal reason to be proud of what you've overcome in order to ensure that future generations will continue to enjoy the fruits of democracy and freedom. It has taken enormous energy and commitment. With courage and tenacity, you cast off the chains of a dictatorship, defeated those who would have subverted your cause, and have built a government based on the popular vote and the respect for human rights. I'm pleased to have this opportunity to salute your personal courage and leadership. Mr. Prime Minister, we applaud what you and the people of Portugal have accomplished together. I also want to extend my thanks for Portugal's continuing contribution to the Western Alliance. This is even more meaningful now that you have proudly joined the ranks of the democratic nations. The ever more apparent failure of communism, wherever it has been tried, makes it increasingly important for the free people of the world to stand together. John Dos Passos, an American writer, who, like so many of our fellow citizens, had family roots in Portugal, wrote late in his life, "Marxism has not only failed to promote human freedom, it has failed to produce food. History is on the side of the free, because freedom is right and because freedom works. Only in democratic countries is the individual free to create and dream without fear, to profit from the product of one's labor and investment or investment, to organize unions and cooperative efforts with like-minded peoples, to peacefully try to change what is into something totally new and different. Under freedom, innovation and ideas are unleashed that otherwise would be smothered by oppression and control. Free people are not afraid of change. In market economies, change becomes a means of creating new wealth by meeting the needs and wants of others and by doing it cheaper and better. Mr. Prime Minister, we're aware of the economic challenges that you face. It wasn't that long ago when we in the United States found ourselves with similar economic difficulties. We decided to shun regulatory and redistribution schemes and instead put in place incentives for our people to work and produce and invest, freeing our economy to grow. Every country must find its own way, but I would hope that our experience and the success that we've enjoyed might provide encouragement for others. We want Portugal to succeed and your people to prosper. A recent investment mission here by American firms was sponsored by our two governments. This is the type of private sector activity which serves the interests of both our peoples. Our cooperation in educational endeavors, as we're doing in the Fulbright program, will also reap many rewards in the future. Let us see to it that these positive steps are only the first of many. The recent establishment of the Luso-American Foundation bodes well for the relations between our governments and our peoples. Today, we're laying the foundation for the progress and freedom our children will enjoy. What we do today is for them tomorrow. They'll stand on our shoulders, and we must give them strong backs so they may see well into the future. And it will be people like you, Mr. Prime Minister, to whom future generations will be most grateful. You can be especially proud of your strong leadership in bringing democracy to Portugal. So, please join me in a toast to Prime Minister Soares and to the Portuguese people who build the future of freedom and progress.
assessment of the council, I think about the trip, the overall assessment of the trip, you're almost at the end now.
What's that?
Could you give us your overall feeling about the trip?
Later, I think we're thinking about maybe making that possible for the trip tour.
Good lights, please. Have you discussed military issues here in Lisbon?
What?
Have you discussed here military issues in Lisbon with Portuguese government?
Yes, we've talked about that. We're very close allies. And we value very highly the cooperative arrangement that we have with regard to bases like Lages.
Would America ask for more facilities in Portugal?
We don't want to impose, we want to continue to cooperate.
TV line.